Let us begin today with the modal auxiliaries. Well, modals are those auxiliary verbs or helping verbs which express the mode or manner of the actions indicated by the main verb. And out of all the auxiliary verbs, modals have their own importance because they are used as a helping verb and they also express the mode or manner of the action without expressing the particular word for the manner and the mode. So modals are those auxiliary verbs or helping verbs. Auxiliary means helping, which express the mode or manner of the actions indicated by the main verb. They express modes such as ability, possibility, permission, obligation, etc. For example, we can speak in English. This sentence shows ability of speaking English. The next sentence, it might rain in the evening. In this sentence, might shows possibility of raining in the evening. The third one, may I go to watch a movie? In this sentence, may expresses permission. To seek permission, we use may. In the fourth sentence, you must do your duty. Must here in this sentence expresses obligation. So in this manner, all the modals express some modes or manners. Okay, and they are also used as the helping verbs. Okay, now let us come to the uses of modals. First, a modal does not change according to the number or person of the subject. Even if the subject is singular or plural, we use the same modal for both the singular and the plural subject. Okay, so modals are not used according to the number and person of the subject. For example, she can play. Here we have used can with she, and I can play. Here we have used can with I also, and you can play. In all these three sentences, we have used can with three different subjects. Okay, so this is quite clear that modals are not used according to the number or person of the subject. Okay, a modal is always used with a verb in its basic form. So whenever we use a modal, we should use the first form of the verb. Okay, because modals always take the first form of the main verb. The modal takes the tense while the main verb remains in its dictionary form. Okay, for example, I can speak. The sentence is in present tense and we have used speak, the basic form of the verb speak. Okay, and if I say the same sentence in the past, I would say it like this: I could speak. Here also, to show the past tense of sentence, we have used the basic form of the verb. Okay, the third point to be remembered while using the modals is modals can be used alone in response to a question. In response to a question, especially the yes no type questions. Okay, so whenever we are answering the yes no type questions, we can use modals alone. Okay, like if I ask, can you speak English? This is the question. Okay, and the answer of this question can be given like this: yes, I can. So while responding to the questions, especially the yes no type questions, we can use the modals alone. Okay, the fourth point to be remembered is that modals, when joined with not to form a negative, can be contracted. We can say can't in place of cannot. This is the contracted negative form of cannot. okay. Mustn't is the contracted negative form for must not. Shan't is the contracted negative form of shall not. Won't is the contracted negative form of will not. So modals with not can also be contracted like the following contracted modals. Okay, now let us come to the important modal auxiliaries, okay, and their uses. So let us first discuss about the uses of can. Can is generally used in the present tense to show ability, capacity, capability, power, strength, know-how to, permission. For example, he can defeat you. In this sentence, I have used can to show power or strength. Okay, another sentence, Mridul can solve this question in a minute. This sentence shows ability or capacity. Next sentence, you have done your work, so you can go now. This sentence shows or expresses permission. Whenever we grant permission, we can use can for granting the permission. Okay, so in this manner modals are used. Okay, and can is generally used in the present tense. Okay, and the past tense of can is could. Okay, so could is used as the past tense of can. Okay, could is also used to express polite request. It is also used to show possibility. Okay, and could is also used to seek permission or to grant permission. For example, he said that he could solve the problem. In this sentence, could is used to express the ability in the past tense, so it has been used here as the past tense of can. Okay, next sentence, this problem could be solved. Here in this sentence, could is used to express possibility in the past. Okay, and could I use your cell phone? In this sentence could expresses a polite request. Okay, so the could is also used to express conditional possibility. For example, if I had the money, I could buy a new house. In the hypothetical conditions, we use could to express a conditional possibility. And in the fourth sentence also, we have used could to express conditional possibility. Next, shall. And shall is used in first person to give information about future action. Okay, shall is used in second and third person to express command, order, promise, threat, challenge, warning, and suggestion. For example, I shall finish this topic by tomorrow. In the first sentence, shall expresses the future the action. Okay, and so it is used with the first person. Okay, the second sentence is, you shall leave the class at once. In the second sentence, shall is used to show command or order. Okay, and so it has been used with the second person. The third sentence is, she shall study regularly and succeed. She shall study regularly and succeed. In this sentence, shall expresses determination. Okay, and so it has been used with the third person. Next sentence, if you make a noise, you shall be punished. In this sentence, shall is used to express threat or warning. Okay, some more example, he shall get a prize. In this sentence, shall is used to express promise. Okay, some other uses of shall are in interrogative sentence. In interrogative sentences, shall is used with first person to indicate offer or suggestion. For example, if I say, shall I hire a taxi for you It's a kind of offer or suggestion, okay, which is expressed in the interrogation. Okay. Next, shall can be used also with third person to know the desire of the person spoken. Okay. The above sentence is the example of this statement also. And we may also say, shall I make a cup of coffee for you? In this sentence, shall is used to know the desire of the person spoken to. Okay. And the past tense of shall is should. Okay. So let us come to the next model, should. I think we all are aware with this model. Okay. And should is generally used as the past tense of shall in indirect speech. For example, I said that I should succeed. I said that I should succeed. In this sentence, should expresses the past tense of shall. Okay.
Change hi nahi ho raha.
Furthermore, should is also used to express duty or obligation. Duty or obligation. And duty and obligation should be moral, especially the moral duty and the moral obligation. Okay. So, for example, if I say we should protect trees, when I say we should protect trees, it suggests that it is our moral duty to protect the trees. Some more sentences: you should respect your elders and teachers. In this sentence also, should expresses a moral obligation and a kind of advice. Okay, should is also used to express condition. In the hypothetical or imaginary conditions, we use should in the main clause. For example, if you were a teacher, you should be polite and decent. Should is also used to express request. For example, I should like to inform you about my inability to come. Here in this sentence, should expresses a request. Okay. Should is also used to express an advice. Okay, so if I say you should consult a doctor, it's a kind of advice which one gives to another. You should consult a doctor as you look ill. So it's a kind of advice in this sentence. Okay. So these are the various models and their uses. Okay. And we end this lecture with one more model, will. Okay, and will is used in second person and third person to express certainty. For example, you will begin the work tomorrow. Okay, in this sentence, will show certainty. Okay. Will is, here we should keep this thing in mind that in modern English there is a tendency to use will in all persons. To indicate future action, to indicate future tense, request, promise, determination, intention, habit, and characteristic. For example, my friend will come tomorrow. This sentence shows future tense. In this sentence will show the future tense or a future action. Okay. And will you have coffee? This shows a kind of request. Okay. Next, I will take care of your brother. In this sentence will shows promise. So in this manner will is used with all the persons to show future tense, request, promise, determination, intention, habit, and characteristic. So that's all for today. We'll continue the topic in the next lecture.